So now we'll talk about the second tube parameter, which is called the plate resistance. So first let us talk about what do we understand by this term. Now the space charge that offers an internal opposition to the flow of electrons actually this and this is done from the cathode to the plate of the vacuum tube and give rise to an internal resistance is nothing but termed as the plate resistance. So the plate resistance for the flow of steady current that is given by DC is different from the plate resistance for the flow of alternating current. And you know the abbreviation, it is AC. So AC. So the plate current is actually, it is defined as the ratio of steady plate potential to the steady plate current, so to steady plate current in accordance to, and the law here, there will be a use of law with Ohm's law or Ohm's law. Now we talk about the dynamic or AC plate resistance. So this is defined as the ratio of small change. So ratio of small change in plate potential, and this is given by, so plate potential given by delta EB to the corresponding small change in plate current, and this is, so this is the plate current corresponding change, and this is given by delta IB when the grid potential is actually, so this is the condition that you must be aware of and should be more in mind, is kept constant. So how it will look like? It will look something like this. So RP subscript P will be delta EB by delta IB into IB. This is equal to del EB by del IB into IB. Next we move on to the mutual conductance. So mutual conductance, or you can even term it as transconductance. So this tells us the effectiveness of the grid voltage actually in bringing about change in current plate. The change in current plate, and this is done when the current plate potential is kept constant. So let us look at its definition. It is defined as the ratio of small change in plate current actually, and this plate current is given by delta IB to the small change in grid potential. This is given by delta CE when the plate potential is actually kept constant. So what we see here is that it doesn't matter whether we talk about amplification factor, plate resistance, mutual conductance, somewhere or the other, something has been constant. That means some assumption has to be made, okay, prior to define anything. So kept constant. So how it will look like? So the formula becomes Gm equals minus delta Ib by delta Ce Cb, and this is equal to minus del Ib by del Ce into Cb. Now let us know the relation between the two parameters. That means how these, so we have talked about them individually, but now we will see how the two parameters are related to each other. So let's do the analysis now. Now in a triode valve, the plate current, which is given by Ib, so let me write it down, current Ib is a function of, so it becomes a function of plate voltage. This plate voltage is nothing but our Eb, and grid voltage, which is actually denoted by, so grid voltage Ec. Okay, now Ib, so the thing which we have just written in terms, let us write it in functional form using notation. So it becomes a function of CBF and EC. Okay, so therefore DIB will be del IB by del EB into DEB plus del IB. So I have actually need to make some correction. This will be just EB. So del IB this will be, and del EC DEC. So we have direct as well as partial derivatives. Okay, we are representing it in this form. Now you must remember that when the change in grid and potential and plate potential are such that plate current remains constant, we have the following. That means the your left hand side will be constant, so DIB will be equal to 0. Therefore del IB by D del EB into DEB plus del IB in by del EC into DEC will be actually equal to 0. So from here we can get, actually we need, what we need to compute is the value of DEB by DEC. Okay, so we want this. So we can write the above as minus DEB. So it takes the form, and this denominator will be EC. So you have del IB by del EC by del IB by del EB. So, or we can rewrite this as mu is equal to Gm into Rp. What are these three things? U or mu is nothing but minus this part. Okay, so this is nothing but our amplification factor. So the mu actually represents the amplification factor. Next we have Gm, or you can even say Rp, anyone you can take. Rp is nothing but the, it is given by del EB by del IB, okay, which is this part. So this can be rewritten as the plate resistance and lastly we have the last term, which is GM, and GM is nothing but our mutual conductance. So these are, so what we get is that amplification factor given by mu is actually equal to the product of plate resistance, that is given by our R subscript P, and mutual conductance given by G subscript M. Now what we are gonna do in our next tutorial is we will try and learn about the function of triode valve.